A recent report from the Condition of Education examined employment outcomes of young adults ages 25 to 29 with a bachelor's degree. In 2012, 32%, or about 1 in 3 young adults, had a bachelor's degree or higher. Recent data tell us that young adults with a bachelor's degree earn more than twice as much as those without a high school credential and have an unemployment rate that is less than half the rate for those without a high school credential. In 2012, the median earnings for young bachelor's degree holders who worked in full-time jobs were $44,500. The average unemployment rate for these young bachelor's degree holders was 4.8%. While people with bachelor's degrees tend to have more favorable employment outcomes than people with lower levels of education, earnings and unemployment rates differ substantially among people with different undergraduate majors. The most common undergraduate fields were biology, business, communications, and psychology. In 2012, young adults with bachelor's degrees in communications and psychology had median earnings that were lower than those for bachelor's degrees overall. Median earnings were $40,200 for young adults with bachelor's degrees in communications and $38,300 for those with bachelor's degrees in psychology. Median earnings for young adults with a business or biology degree were not measurably different from the median for bachelor's degrees overall. At one end of the earnings spectrum, young adults with bachelor's degrees in electrical engineering, mechanical engineering, and computer and information systems had some of the highest median earnings. For example, in 2012, the median earnings for young adults with a bachelor's degree in electrical engineering were $69,100. At the other end of the spectrum, young adults with bachelor's degrees in social work and human services, liberal arts and humanities, and elementary education had some of the lowest median earnings. For example, the median earnings for young adults with a bachelor's degree in social work and human services were $34,200. This was about half of the average median earnings for those with the highest paid majors. There were also differences in unemployment rates. In 2012, the unemployment rate was lowest for young adults with bachelor's degrees in mathematics, mechanical engineering, and elementary education, but was highest for young adults with bachelor's degrees in political science and government and fine arts. Some fields of study had higher than average earnings and lower than average unemployment rates. For example, the median earnings for young adults with bachelor's degrees in mechanical engineering were $65,200, which was higher than the median for bachelor's degrees overall. In addition, the unemployment rate for young adults with bachelor's degrees in mechanical engineering was 2.7%, which was lower than the unemployment rate for all fields of study. Young adults with bachelor's degrees in nursing also had higher median earnings and lower than average unemployment rates. By contrast, young adults with bachelor's degrees in fine arts had lower median earnings at $36,200 and an above average unemployment rate at 6.6%. In addition to examining how employment outcomes vary by undergraduate field of study, the recent report also examined how employment outcomes in general have changed between 2009 and 2012 for young adults with bachelor's degrees. The average unemployment rate for young adults with a bachelor's degree dropped from 5.2% in 2009 to 4.8% in 2012. Despite this improvement, the median annual earnings for persons in this age group decreased from $48,000 in 2009 to $44,500 in 2012 after adjusting for inflation. Visit nces.ed.gov to view the full report and learn more about the condition and progress of American education.